A regularly scheduled flight from Los Angeles International Airport to Cairo, Egypt, with a stop at John F. Kennedy Airport in New York. That was the plan for Egypt Air Flight 990. But on October 31, 1999, the Boeing 767 crashed into the Atlantic Ocean, about 60 miles off the coast of Massachusetts.
I lost contact with the Boeing 767 in my airspace.
The Egypt Air?
Yeah, I mean, we lost radar, we lost everything.
Crash investigators say the co-pilot had learned he was being demoted and took control of the plane when the captain stepped out of the cockpit, sending it into a nosedive toward the ocean. The cockpit voice recorder revealed the co-pilot repeated, "I rely on God," 11 times just before the crash. The captain can be heard on the recorder saying, "What's happening?" Even more chilling, the last words heard are the captain saying, "Pull with me," as he struggled to get his plane to change course. In that instant, the co-pilot turns off the engine, sending the aircraft slamming into the sea. All 217 people on board were killed.
Any luck with Egypt Air?
No.
Nothing?
No.
With Egypt Air, the transponder stopped working and there was no mayday call. The NTSB ruled the co-pilot intentionally crashed the plane, though Egyptian authorities still say it was a mechanical failure.
Certainly, pilots are part of the potential for the problem, so they have to be looked at. But basically, it's not a guilty till proven innocent, really. I mean, because there's only a few sources that could cause this type of problem. Someone outside the cockpit, certainly the people inside the cockpit.
A suicidal pilot was also to blame for this. December 1997, the crash of Silk Air Flight 185. It was heading from Jakarta, Indonesia, to Singapore when it crashed into this river.
It sounded like a bomb dropping. The first explosion was up in the air, then it exploded again, then it crashed into the water.
The plane dropped into the river in less than a minute, breaking the speed of sound and killing all 104 passengers and crew. The NTSB concluded that the pilot deliberately directed the flight to crash. In Indonesia, they claim the findings are inconclusive. Randy Kaye, CNN, New York.